Namaste, welcome to online classes. If in previous class we have discussed about inline functions and before that we have discussed about function overloading, today I am going to continue the advantages and disadvantages of inline functions. Yesterday we have studied inline function. I hope all of you remember definition of inline function and characteristics of inline function. Definition of inline function, I'll just repeat once again. Inline function is a function in which the function call is replaced by function body. Function call is replaced by function body, and we start the inline function definition by using a keyword inline. We can make out the function as an inline through the keyword inline. And here the function call is replaced by function body, and it executes little faster compared to normal functions. These are the characteristics what we have studied in previous class. Now I'll move on to advantages of inline function. First advantage is compact function calls. Already we have studied inline is a short function. So compact in the sense short. Compact function calls, it is a short function. Compact function calls means it is a short function. Second one, speed of the execution of a program increases. When the function is very small, obviously it executes faster. Speed of the execution of a program increases because here function is smaller, and when the function is called, the function call is replaced by function body. So whatever the overheads are there in a normal function are avoided in case of inline function. So inline function executes faster because there is no need of passing a parameter to the function, no need to allocate a extra memory for the local variables. So we can say it executes faster. Next one, very efficient code can be generated. Suppose if it has some of the good features like this, we can say we can develop very efficient code. Program, very efficient program can be developed. Last one, readability of the program increases. Readability of the program increases. It means that in case of inline function, function call is replaced by function body. So when the function is invoked, when the inline function is invoked, there is no need to transfer the control from the calling point to the called function. So function call is replaced by function body. No need to transfer the control to the function body. Function call is replaced by function body. So when you see a program, the function, when you read a program, it will be in readable form, one after the another. First we'll see a class definition, next there will be a function definition, after that there is a main program, whatever we have studied in the previous class. First class I taught you, next I defined a function, after that I have explained you how the main executes. When you start execution from the main program, the function call will be replaced by function body. So when we read a program, when the compiler reads a program, it will be in a readable form. So we can say readability of the program increases. Next, disadvantage, that is size of the executable file increases and more memory is needed. Disadvantage is that size of the executable file increases and more memory is needed. That means when we invoke a function, function call is replaced by function body. When we call a function one time, function call will be replaced by function body only one time. Suppose if we call a function twice, function call will be replaced by function body twice. So when you see a program, the function body will be replaced twice, so it will be displayed twice in a particular memory locations. So as you call a particular function many number of times, the more memory is required to store the function body instead of function call. So we can say the size of the executable file increases and more memory is required. I'll just repeat the advantages and disadvantages. Advantages: first one is compact function call. It is a small function, so we can say compact function calls. Second one, speed of the execution of a program increases. Function is small, so execution will be very faster. Next, very efficient code can be generated. Suppose if any particular concept has some good features, we can be able to develop efficient codes. Code in the sense programs. Readability of the program increases. That is, function call is replaced by function body, so compiler can read the program in sequence one after the another. Next, disadvantages: size of the executable file increases and more memory is needed. That is, when you call a inline function many number of times, function call will be replaced by function body many number of times. So executable file size will be increased. When the file size increases, it needs more memory to store it. Next, I'll move on to lab program related for inline function. Yesterday we have just considered a simple example to find out a cube of a number using inline function, but this is same, but this is the same program, but I'm using class to do the class to find out a cube of a inline number. I'll start with class. This is a program to find out cube of a number using class. Yesterday we have studied a simple program to find out a cube of a number. Today I am doing the same program but using class structure. Class si, int n, public, si int n n, n is equal to nn, close the flower bracket, int cube, end of a class, put semicolon. Now this is a class structure. This is a class structure. Class name is si int n. It is a data member of a class. N is a data member of a class. Here you can see I have not written private, protected, public, but by default it will be considered as private. Okay, int n, here n is considered as a private data member. Next, public. Under public I have written si int n n, n is equal to nn. Here I have used a constructor. You will be studying this particular topic in the next classes. Si int n n, it is a constructor. Si is a constructor. We can say si as a constructor because it has the same name as a class name. It is also a member function. Si int n n, it is a member function. It is a special member function which is used to initialize the data members of a class. Si is a special member function which we call as a constructor. Constructor is used to initialize the object of a class. Initializing the object means giving a initial value for the data members of a class. That is, here n is initialized to n n. In n is initialized with the value n n. So we use a constructor si to initialize a value for variable n. Here n is a data member of a class. Si is a constructor. How we can make out si is a constructor? That is by looking at the name of the function. Function name is same as a class name, then it is a constructor. It has a argument here, so we can call it as a parameterized constructor. It is a parameterized constructor. Next, int cube. It is a normal member function, what we use always in our classes, int cube. Int is a return type, cube is a function name. Next, we'll move on to defining a function outside a class. Here int cube is a function. We define cube function outside a class. Here we want to consider cube as a inline because this is a program given to find out a cube of a number using inline function. So we'll consider this as a inline by using a keyword inline. Inline. Next, as usual, how to define a member function outside the class? That is return type, class name, scope resolution operator, function name. That is, int is a return type, assign is a class name, scope resolution operator used to define a member function outside a class, cube is a function name. And here it is an inline function, so we use a keyword inline. Next, what it does? It finds a cube of a number. So I'll write return n into n into n. Next, I'll move on to main function. If you have a class, you have to create a object for the class. And if you want a variables inside a main, you have to declare those variables. So here I want to find a cube of a number n. So I first declare a variable n, int n, declare a variable n. I am finding cube of a number n. So you have to declare a variable n. Cout enter n. Cout enter n. It will be displayed on the output screen. In the output screen, enter n will be displayed. Enter n. C in n. Suppose if I enter a value here 5, it will be read by C in statement. I enter a value 5, that 5 will be read by C in statement. S sign A is equal to n. S sign is a class name. A is a object name. Here I am creating an object for the class. Here I am creating an object for the class. Sn is a class name. A is a object name. Equal n. N is a value given here. N is a value what I have input. Okay. So sn a is equal to 5. Sn a is equal to n. That is sn object a equal to 5. What it does? When there is a constructor, I told this is a constructor, right? This is a constructor. When there is a constructor, when we create a object, constructor will be called automatically. Okay? When we create a object, constructor will be called automatically. Here I am using a constructor si to initialize the value for n. So when I create an object here, sn a, it is object creation. When I create object a, control here, there is a call to the parameterized constructor. Here there is a call to this particular constructor. So control directly comes here, okay? And here what is the value we have assigned? Equal to 5. So this 5 is assigned here. Nn gets the value 5. Okay, when there is a parameterized constructor, then if you create the object, the constructor will be called automatically. Here we have written equal to 5, so this 5 is assigned to nn. So this nn value in turn assigned to n. This 5 value is assigned to n. So now our data member n gets the value 5. Data member n gets the value 5. Okay. Next, again we'll start from here. That work is over. Here it is got executed. Now control comes back to the main. Cout cube is equal to a dot cube. You can call it like a function how you call other member functions. You can call cube function how you call other member function, that is object name dot cube. Cube is a function name. So a dot cube. Here there is a call to the member function. But when there is a call to inline function, the control does not transfer here. It is not going to happen. Control does not transfer to the function. Instead of that, function body will be substituted here. What is the function body? That is return n into n. Okay? Return n into n. So here it calculates what is 5 into 5 into 5. That is 125. It is a inline function. So when there is a call a dot cube, the control does not transfer to this function. Instead of that, the function body, what is given here, return n into n, that is substituted here, and it calculates what is 5 into 5 into 5, and we get the answer as 125. This a dot cube is under cout statement. So cout cube is equal to a dot cube. Here cube is equal to within a double quotation, so it will be displayed as it is. Cube is equal to within a double quotation, so it will be displayed as it is a dot cube. What's the value we have calculated? 5 into 5 into 5, that is 125. That is displayed like this. So we get the answer as cube is equal to 125. Here, one is the main thing what we have used is constructor, that you will be studying in the next classes. Constructor is used to initialize the object of a class. Initializing the object means initializing data members of a class. So here sn is used to initialize the value for n. And cube function, it is an inline function, so I am using keyword inline, and we are finding return n into n, cube of a number. Next, here void main, execution starts from void main. Here I am finding cube of a number n, so declare a variable n and input a value for n, Next, create object for the class. We are using a class here, so create object for the class. Assign A is equal to N. Here, when the object is created, there is a call to the constructor. Whenever we use a constructor, when you create an object, the control directly goes to constructor to initialize the object. Okay, it initializes the object, that is initializing the data members. Okay, here it NN gets the value 5 and 5 value in turn assigned to N. Finally, you use cout statement to call a function and also to display. Okay, here function will be called. So when the function is called, function call is replaced by function body. Finally, it will be output using cout statement. We have finished inline functions by this. Next, we'll move on to one more function what we use in the class, that is a friend function. Friend function, it is a non-member function. Friend function is a non-member function. We'll see where we have to use a friend function. Assume a situation where there are two classes. Both the classes wants to share a same function code. Okay? Assume there are two classes, class A and class B. Both wants to share a same set of code. Then we can create one common function code. We can create one common function code and we'll consider it as a friend. Okay? We'll consider one set of common function code and we'll consider it as a friend. Okay? And this friend code allows us to access the private and protected members of both the classes, class A and also even class B. Okay? Friend function allows us to access both the private and protected members of both the classes, class A's and class B's. Suppose if you have two classes, both the classes wants to access the same set of code, then we can create a one function and we can allow that function to share among two classes. That common set of code is known as a friend. Okay, in C++ we have a friend concept in a class, in a friend function concept, which helps us to share a common function code between number of classes, between two or more classes. Okay, now we'll see what is the friend function. It is a non-member function. It is a non-member function. All of you know that private data members are accessed only by the member functions of the same class, right? But now here we are telling that friend function is a non-member function, but still it can be able to access private and protected members of a class because it is a friend. It is a friend for two or more classes. So it is allowed to access private and protected members of a class. Okay? It can access private and protected members of a class. Friend function is a non-member function which can access private and protected members of a class. Okay? Usually non-member function is not given a right to access private and protected members of a class. But if it is a friend function, it is given the right to access private and protected members of a class. That is the difference between ordinary member functions and friend functions. Okay, friend function is a common set of code which can be accessed by two or more classes, and also it allows to access private and protected members of a class. So we'll see the definition. Definition is, it is a non-member function which can access private and protected members of a class. Now we'll see how to declare a friend function, how to define a friend function. I'll just write syntax. This is a this is the syntax of declaration of friend function. Okay, this is how we are going to declare a friend function. Friend function is declared inside a class. Okay, friend function is declared inside a class. That is how we can make out it is a friend function. That is through the keyword friend. Okay, if we use the keyword friend, we can say it is a friend function. Friend and rest of the things are as usual. How to declare a ordinary function, that is return type, next function name, next argument list. Here argument is a object of a particular class. Here argument is object of particular class. Instead of argument, even I can write like this: class name object name. Syntax is class name, friend, return type, function name, arguments. Argument is a object of a particular class. Function name is a name of the function. Return type is a, it may be integer return type, float return type, anything it is, depending on your program. Friend identifies it is a friend function. Here you can see, had I written it under any private, public, protected? No. That means we can declare it anywhere in the class. Either we can declare friend under private or public or under protected. Okay. This is about the syntax. I'll just move on to very simple program related for a friend function. This is a simple example for friend function where we find out sum of two numbers. Here class name is considered as base, A and B are the data members, public void get data, int I int j, this is a function, public is a access specifier, void get data is a member function with the parameters, arguments. Friend int sum base ob, it is a friend function, and this is a definition of a friend function. Int sum base b1, return b1.a plus b1.b, this is a definition of a friend function. This is just a declaration. This is just declaration of a friend function. Here we use friend keyword. This is definition of a friend function. Here no need to use a keyword friend. and even no need to use a scope resolution operator. Here, when you define a member function, that is a friend function, when you define a friend function outside a class, no need to use a scope resolution operator or even a friend keyword. Next, void main. This is a main function, and here you have to declare a variable, that is a variable of class base B. Here B is a object, or you can also call it as a variable of a class base. Next, this is calling a function B dot get data, and this is calling of a friend function. Now we'll see how the execution is done here. Void main execution always starts from void main base B. Here B is a object created for the class base. B is the object created for the class base. Next, B dot get data 10, 20. This is B is a object, dot operator, get data. This is calling of a member function. How to call a member function? That is object name dot function name, B dot get data. Here in the function definition, we have a arguments, we have a parameters or arguments. So here also you have to pass arguments 10 and 20. So when there is a call to a function, control directly comes to function. Control directly comes to function by passing the value 10, 20. Passing the value 10, 20. Here 10 is assigned to I and 20 is assigned to J. 10 is assigned to I, 20 is assigned to J. So A is equal to I. So A gets the value 10 and B gets the value of J. What is the value of J? That is 20. So A value is 10, B value is 20. Here B dot get data 10, 20. Here we are calling a function get data by passing the value 10, 20. Control directly comes to a function get data by passing the value 10 and 20. 10 is assigned to I and 20 is assigned to J. In turn, A is equal to I means I's value is assigned to A, that is 10. J's value is assigned to B, that is 20. So we get A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20. Next, we'll move on to next statement in a main function. C out sum is equal to. Now we have given a value for A and B. Now we have to find out what is A plus B. So we have to call a function sum. Sum is what function? Sum is a friend function. Friend function can be invoked like a normal function. Friend function is invoked like a normal function. That is without using any object. No need to use any object here. Sum of B. Here we are passing the object. Here we are passing the object. Sum is a function name. B is a object name. What is B? B is a object created for a class base. So we are passing object when we call a sum function. C out sum is equal to sum B. Here we are calling a function sum. Calling a function sum by passing the object B. So control directly goes to sum function passing the object B. So B is copied to B1. B is copied to B1. What is B actually? B is a object. It is associated with values of A and B. That is A value is 10, B value is 20. B is a object. It is associated with the data members A and B, and its value is 10 and 20. That is copied to B1. B value is copied to B1. Next, return B1.A plus B1.B. B1.A plus B1.B. Here A is 10, B is 20, that is the data members associated with B. Now you have copied B to B1. B to B1. B is copied to B1. So B1 also associated with data members A and B. Its value is 10 and 20. Here you are copying B2, B1. B is associated with the value, with data members A and B, its value 10 and 20. When we copy B to B1, B1 also gets the associated data members A and B, and its values 10 and 20. So, return B1.A plus B1.B means it returns the value of B1.A. B1.A is what? 10. B1.A is 10. Plus B1.B. B1.B is also, B is 20. So, 10 plus 20. Return 10 plus 20. What is the value? That is 30. Return 30. Control directly comes to Cout statement. Control directly comes to Cout statement. That is to the point here. Control directly comes to Cout statement. That is to the calling point sum of B. The value is returned is 30. Value returned is 30. Cout sum is equal to 30. So in the output screen, you get the answer as sum is equal to 30. In the output screen, you get sum is equal to 30. I'll just explain how to call a function, sum, how to call a friend function. Friend function is invoked like a normal function. That is sum B. Here, B is a object. It is associated with data members A and B. It has a value 10 and 20. When the function is called, control directly goes to function. B is copied to B1. So, B1 also will get associated with A and B. A's value is 10, B's value is 20. Now, get into the function. Return B1.A plus B1.B. What is B1.A? B1.A is 10. B1.B is 20. So, we get 10 plus 20, that is equal to 30. Return 30. Return 30 value to the calling point. That is to sum of B. Here we get the value as 30. Next output, see out, sum is equal to 30. So here in the output screen we get sum is equal to 30. This is how the friend function execution takes place. Here while looking at this program, you can be able to say what are the characteristics of friend function. I'll move on to characteristics of friend function. First characteristic is nothing but the definition of a friend function. What is the definition of a friend function? Friend function is a non-member function which can be able to access private and protected members. It is a non-member function which can be able to access private and protected members of a class. That is the first characteristic. Second one, it is invoked like a normal function. Invoking means calling. It can be invoked like a normal function. Just see how we have invoked a friend function. How we have invoked? That is just sum of B. Here sum is a function name, B is a argument. Here we are not using any object. If it is a member function, we have to call a member function by using object name dot function name argument list. Suppose if it is a friend function, call it like a normal function. That is just function name and argument list. Next one, declaration can be placed anywhere in the class. Declaration of a friend function can be placed anywhere in the class. Here I have placed it under public. This is the declaration of a friend function. Friend, int, sum, base, ob. It is a declaration of a friend function. I placed it under public. But you can also place it under private or protected. Anywhere in the class we can place it. Either under public or under private or under protected. Next one is, it cannot access members directly. It cannot access members directly. Members, that is a data members. I am talking about data members, that is A and B. It cannot access the data members A and B directly. That means it has to use object name with the dot operator. When you access A and B, you cannot access it directly as A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20. But when you want to access it, you have to access it as B1.A, B1.B. That is object name and dot operator must be used. Next, last one is, it must be declared with the keyword friend. It must be declared with the keyword friend. You can see declaration. This is the declaration of a friend function. When you can say it is a declaration, that is, there is no function body. Here, there is no function body, so you can say it is a declaration. There is a function body, so you can say that is a definition. During declaration, you have to use a keyword friend, but during definition, no need to use a friend keyword. Even scope resolution operator is also not necessary. Okay? This is about the characteristics of a friend function. You know, first one is a definition. Second one, it is invoked like a normal function. Third one, it can be placed anywhere in the class, either under public, private or protected. Next one, it cannot access data members directly. It must be accessed like b1.a and b1.b. Last one, it must be declared with the keyword friend. Here we have written it, friend int sum base ob, but it's not defined with the keyword friend or even not with the scope resolution operator. Okay, now this is the end of the function overloading chapter, and here most of the questions are very important: friend function, inline function and function overloading. As I said in the beginning, one of the 5 marks question appears from this particular chapter.